so now it's the Richard E. Bellman Control Heritage Award. It's given for distinguished career contributions to the theory or application of automatic control. It's the highest A²C² recognition of professional achievement for control systems engineers and scientists. Richard's career was at Princeton Rand and at USC. He was a pioneer in modern optimization system analysis and control theory, developed dynamic programming, invariant embedding, and quasi-linearization, published several influential books. And the recipient is Masayoshi Tomizuka. Seminal and pioneering contributions to the theory and practice of mechatronic systems. So Tommy will give a short speech about his career.
Dear presenters, colleagues, students, ladies and gentlemen, I'm tremendously honored to receive the Richard E. Bellman Control Heritage Award. Thank you to those who nominated me and supported my nomination, to the selection committee, and to the A²C² Board for making me this year's recipient. I'm grateful to my teachers and colleagues at Keio University, Japan, where I did my undergraduate studies, MIT, where I did my graduate studies, and the University of California, Berkeley, where I have been teaching for the last 44 years. I thank, in particular, my PhD advisor, Dan Whitney, my control colleagues at Berkeley, and the many bright graduate students that I presently have and have had in my lab. I thank NSF and the many that are other government and industrial sponsors who provided me resources to maintain my mechanical systems control laboratory, the home of my research group. Last but not least, I thank my wife Milwaukke for supporting me and our family, permitting me to focus on academics and schoolwork for many years, starting almost 50 years ago in my MIT days. I was introduced to the field of dynamic systems and control during my senior year at Keio University. There was no internet back then, of course, so I read periodicals such as IEEE Transaction on Automatic Control and ASME Journal of Basic Engineering in the Library to find the latest development in this field. Around the time I completed my MS at Keio, I received an offer to attend MIT. In addition to reading the research results in publications, I was excited to find myself in a place where the research was being performed. There, I was inspired by many people and fellow students. Professor Tom Sheridan's early work on linear control was the starting point of my dissertation work on the optimal finite preview problem. Since joining Berkeley in 1974, I have worked on many different mechanical systems. Around that time, large-scale integration technology was starting to make it possible to implement advanced control algorithms by using mini and microcomputers. This allowed me to emphasize both the theoretical aspect of control and the application of control theory in laboratory work. This research approach continues in my laboratory today. Robots are multivariable and nonlinear. A configuration-dependent inertia matrix and nonlinear systems are unique for robots. In the early 1980s, Roberto Horowitz, one of my PhD students, worked with me on model reference adaptive control as it applied to robot. Since then, robot control has remained a major research topic in my group. Our current research emphasizes efficiency and safety in human-robot interactions and merging model-based control and machine learning to make the robot system intelligent. I also did some research on machining. One control issue with machining is the dependence of input-output dynamics on cutting conditions and tool wear. In the early 1980s, Junho Oh, then a PhD student in my lab, demonstrated model reference adaptive control on a old bridgeboard milling machine. It was cleverly implemented and was the first application of modern adaptive control theory to machine. In many mechanical systems involving rotational part, we encounter periodic disturbances with non-periods. Repetitive control is applied to this class of disturbances. After learning of repetitive control from colleagues from Japan in the mid-1980s, I worked with Tsujin Sao, then a PhD student in my lab, to develop our version of repetitive control algorithms, emphasizing discrete time formulation and easy implementation. Another fundamental control problem for mechanical systems is tracking arbitrarily shaped reference input. Feed-forward control is popular in tracking, but unstable system zeros make the problem complicated. To overcome this issue, I suggested canceling phase shift induced by unstable zeros and introduced zero-phase error tracking control in the late 1980s. Since then, this idea has been introduced in many motion control systems, among other applications. In the mid-1980s, UC Berkeley started the program on advanced transit and highway, also known as PATH, under the sponsorship of Caltrans. Automated highway systems was a topic of interest for quite a few control professors at UC Berkeley, and I worked on vehicle controls in the lateral motion lecture. My first PhD student on this topic was Wei Peng, who developed a lateral control method based on preview control. During the past 5 years or so, autonomous vehicles have gained a lot of attention, and students in my laboratory are currently working on bending control and machine learning for application to vehicles. I have been fortunate to have had the opportunity to address a variety of challenging mechanical control problems over the span of my career. My research has been and continues to be rooted in the mechatronic approach, synergistic integration of mechanical systems with sensing, computation, and control theory.
This approach provides the opportunity for academic research to have broad impact on control engineering in practice, and I'm honored to have had a hand in helping to advance a small part of it. Thank you very much for this award. I am extremely grateful and honored.